I want the police, I want everybody to be in Pride. I want Pride to be something that is inclusive in all respects, including the police. But I think in the circumstances, there were some particular, very difficult circumstances that presented themselves this year that no one had expected and that has led us to where we are today. And I'm actually heartened by the fact that all of the statements being issued today by all of those who have been saying some things about this are constructive in tone, are not sort of confrontational or adversarial. They're simply saying that we have work to do.
Toronto police will not march in this year's Pride Parade. Earlier today, the force withdrew its bid to take part in response to outcry in the city's LGBT community. Police were banned from last year's parade, based in part by demands from the Black Lives Matter movement. This year, organizers are angry over how police handled the Bruce MacArthur investigation. He's been charged with first-degree murder in the deaths of six men who were connected to what's often called Toronto's gay village. According to parade organizers, quote, the investigation into their disappearances were insufficient, community knowledge and expertise was not accessed, and despite the fact that many of us felt and voiced our concerns, we were dismissed. This has severely shaken our community's already often tenuous trust in the city's law enforcement. The relationship cannot be mended through a parade. How are police reacting to the backlash, and how do they intend to restore trust with the LGBT community? Joining me now from Toronto is Danielle Bottineau, a Toronto Police Service constable and a member of the city's LGBT community. Hi, Constable Bottineau. Thank you for making time for us today.
Thank you for inviting me.
How did you react when the police were asked to withdraw their application?
You know what, it's been another tough day for me, and it's been disheartening for sure. It's been a pretty heavy day for me, both as a police officer and as a member of the LGBTQ community.
What's disheartening for you specifically?
Unfortunately we're going down this road again. You know, I was asked earlier today if I was disappointed in our reaction as a service and the statement that the chief rolled out. And yeah, I am disappointed, but I'm not disappointed in how the chief responded. I'm more so disappointed in the fact that these six executive directors felt that we needed to go down this route again, and that they didn't have a conversation with us around it. So we were completely caught off guard. We have been in constant communication with various organizations, including Pride Toronto, for some time in regards to moving this relationship forward. That's why it's disheartening for me. I had no idea that this was going to happen.
So you're mostly disappointed in the parade organizers asking the police force not to march?
Absolutely. I mean, we've been having constructive conversations. I've been involved in consultations, and I thought we were taking one step forward with this relationship. Obviously, they see it a different way, and hence why we are where we are today.
As their statement alluded to, and as much of the conversation has proceeded, much of the tension seems to be around the handling of the Bruce MacArthur investigation. Do you think police could have handled it better?
You know what? I think there's always room for improvement. Do I think we were perfect on it? Absolutely not. And, you know, we've been very vocal and supportive of their inquiry taking place, and that will tell. And if we've done something wrong or where we can do better, that's going to show all of that. And I look forward to that inquiry. Myself and the chief have both said that publicly several times, that we think the inquiry is important to regain the trust of the community, but it's going to be a long process moving forward.
Do you understand the concerns that they're voicing, though? The idea that they feel like the force as a whole dismissed their initial worry that their community was being targeted, that your community was being targeted?
I'm completely hearing their voice in that. Absolutely. I understand why they're upset and emotional. I absolutely get that. It's affected both me as a member of the community and other members of our service that are part of the community as well. To know that our community was targeted. And you know what? It doesn't help that the accused came from within the community, which I think everybody on a whole is having a struggle with, because I've talked to several members who knew the accused in some way, shape, or form. And when it's that close to home, it's even a greater struggle for the community.
So what do you tell your colleagues, your fellow police officers, as a member of both communities, about how to repair the trust that has been broken?
It's going to take time. It's going to take one step in front of the other. They're not going to be easy conversations that we need to that we have been having and that we need to continue to have. And you know what? That's going to be a bit of a roller coaster ride, both emotionally for us as well as physically for us. But it's something that we have to do as a service to gain that trust back and to move this relationship forward.
Do you think that there is an understanding among the force that that trust has been broken? I mean, aside from today and being about the parade, do you think there is an understanding among your colleagues that the community felt dismissed?
You know what? I don't know. I can't speak on behalf of my colleagues, to be honest with you. I think our relationship with the community has definitely been strained. I mean, I'm boots on the ground, and I'm in constant contact with the community on a daily basis, so I've heard it all. But I do think that our service is listening, and that their voices are being heard, and that we collectively do truly want to move forward with the community.
And I want to ask you specifically about how the force can do that. But first, I just want to play a clip from the executive director of Pride Toronto, who spoke with CBC earlier today.
Inclusivity isn't about marching in a parade. It's about the real work you do to change the system and the way your organization works so that it equitably serves everybody. And until that happens, there can be no inclusivity. And so marching in a parade as a symbol of inclusivity only masks what the real problems are.
So what are the concrete steps that the force is taking to mend that relationship?
So we've put together a very active community outreach strategy moving forward, and that's been in place for a little bit now. And myself and Deputy McLean have offered for ourselves, and it's already started, to go out to various community organizations to have those conversations, to have those tough questions asked by community members. You know, as much as everybody says that we need to be educated around the community, sometimes the community has to be educated around the service and how we have gone about business. Not saying it's the correct way every single time, but those are the conversations we're having. As well as that we're enhancing our consultative committee. We've had this in place since the early 2000s, and we've brought various organizations to the table, and we're taking a look at how we can better enhance that so that there can be more voices and a greater voice at the table as a whole, because reality is the community is not only in the Church Wellesley Village area, it's across the city, and we need to recognize that the conversations that we're having are not exclusive to the Church Wellesley Village neighborhood. They're across the city, and we need to better support that.
Okay, thanks very much, Constable Danielle Bottineau.
Thank you.